Hey folks, so Bill Camerata noticed it's what's different is my I woke up this morning and flipped on my light, and the lamp that I've been using for 20 something years, I've rigged it together so many times, it died this morning. I actually tried to take it apart to to rig it again, and it said no, we're done. So this is my new $8 lamp. Isn't that nice? So, yeah. So the light's different now. Just getting back from, it's been a busy morning, actually. I was at the post office and spent a couple hours down at the antiquarium. And I hit the back room pretty hard. And so I'm going to show you some of what I've found. This is all for, I bought 25 cents a piece. This is what I got. $16 for all this. Once again, I found some things, and it was Brian today, not Joe. And Brian was a little frustrated, you know, because I always find stuff back there that people overlook. Joe, yesterday had no problem giving me the discount, giving it to me, and Brian did, but he did express his frustration that people weren't more careful. And he said, well, you know, you've spent a ton of money down here, Derek, so, you know, and I said, well, thank you, you know, so hopefully we come across a couple of those. I'll just go down the stack here, and I'll stop at a certain point. On a Czechoslovakian, the Czech Philharmonic Orchestra, doing some Ravel, Daphne and Chloe, and Bolero, in Alvarado del Gracioso. I love Ravel, and as I've said before, I quite enjoy records pressed from different parts of the world, and so this is a, I guess probably the main label in Czechoslovakia, Supraphon. Pick that up. This next one is, I don't know who this artist is, but, you know, it's in great shape. Andre Gagnon, Left Turn. Looks like it might be semi-classical. Could be, it was, again, for 25 cents, and it's in absolutely perfect condition. There's no reason not to take it to find out. Matter of fact, let's go ahead and be brave and drop the needle on this. I played this morning. Thank you so much, Scott. Robert Fripp, love it. David Byrne on the first track. Let's see what this is like. This is the Andre Gagnon. Kind of what I was thinking, you know. We'll leave it on. It's like driving music for the 70s, is what I call it. Is this 70s? 1981. $0.25. Oh, this is horrid. I got to take it off. See, yeah, that's just, oh, God. I won't even go into, okay, so that was 25 cents wasted. I have this, but I couldn't pass it up again. I love this album, Gordon Lightfoot, Summer Side of Life. It's in perfect condition. It's actually in better shape than mine. So this is, it's like never played. 25 cents, still in the shrink wrap. That was a nice find. And I love this album. I love it. Jan Hammer, Black Sheep. And do I have this already? I'm going to just take a quick look. All right, I don't. So another Jan Hammer album for my Jan Hammer solo collection, and it's in great shape. on the Asylum label. Might be on the cheesy side. Peter Frampton, Wind of Change. Now, I don't remember if this is the song I'm thinking, but he has a song. That's not it. Let's see if it's on the other side. I'm hoping this is the song I think it is. Yeah, this is a good song. So this was a nice find for 25 cents. Wind of Change, Peter Frampton. A little crackly. Good old song. I like this. Okay, I'll keep going. Life in the Food Chain, Tony OK. This, when it first came out, there was a bit of a buzz about it. I don't remember why. I had it. My brother, older brother James, really dug this record. I think I ended up either giving it to him or he stole it from me. But this is in excellent condition. I had to grab it for a quarter. Matter of fact, I thought, this is a fine for a quarter. David Newman, Bigger and Better. There were a few copies back there, and I just looked for the one in the best shape. And this has Bernard Purdy on it on drums, Richard Davis bass, Chuck Rainey as well. This could be nice. This, and then the other thing I thought was cool is this is on the old Atlantic label. It's in pretty decent shape. Yeah, it's a quarter. Really, you know, a big part of, as you all know, a big part of the fun of record collecting is the acquisition, the digging and finding. This might be cheese, but I got it. Nat Adderley, A Little New York Midtown Music. I had to grab it because my uncle, Johnny Griffin, he's not my blood uncle, but my uncle Johnny Griffin plays on here. He was like an uncle to me growing up. And it's on the Galaxy label, kind of a low rent. It's a great song. I got this because, again, it's a cool pressing. Passion, Oberammergau. Probably German, Polydor. I just love, it's just like, shoot, it's just too cool for a quarter. You know? And once again, I'll show the vinyl because that's part of the appeal for me. Nice import pressing, I think it's German. Yeah. Fun stuff. 25 cents a piece. How are we doing on time? Just a few more. Love that song. It makes me think of a sunshiny day. Simple Minds. Street Fighting Years. Bit of Ringwear on the cover. Record's in great shape. Another classical one I picked up. Kerensky, Rimsky-Korsakov, Vinyalski. It's on the Turnabout label. Here's a 10-inch I bought that is probably house, but again, 10 inches are kind of fun. Hoover, Drive You Crazy. They had some house in the back room for a quarter, and I was careful with it. There was a lot, and I only got a couple things. Ian Pooley, 900 Degrees, Volume 1. Here's one that was a white label pressing. It says Sidewalk Technician. These anonymous white labels are usually interesting at the very least. This one, Well, I like the cover. It's probably crap, but you know, I went ahead and grabbed it. Dubstar. Anywhere. I have some Dubstar on CD. Hoover Phonic. The cover's trash, but the record's in good shape. Look at that nasty cover. Too Wiki. I really like that song, Too Wiki. Yeah, the record's in good shape. I'll have to literally clean this. DJ Allstar presents Starlight About You. Once again, one of those house records I took a chance on for a quarter this time. Only a quarter. Sebastian Laguerre. Some of his remixes are good when it comes to techno in-house. So I went ahead and grabbed this. Okay, more house. Let's see what else I got besides that stuff. Found another completely anonymous record. Completely an... Oh, wait. Okay, I didn't see that. From Canada, Nero. But it's like with two records in one. From the outside, all I could see was the white label. So I don't know if this is house or techno or drum and bass, but it was, again, everything was a quarter. This one I thought would be interesting. It's still sealed. Yayo, mi salsa, yayo. Still sealed. Order. The Art of Sound Group. Again, this could be terrible, but again, it's still sealed. Really, it didn't look not too bad of a cover, huh? Kind of cool. So I said, hell yes. Look at this. This is trash, but it was like, it was only a quarter. Trans Europe Express. I have, not this one, but I have one of these. There's a series of these that came out. This is, which volume? Volume 2. The records are kind of beat, but it's like, it was only 25 fucking cents, you know? So these babies need, they need some TLC. And, covers all, I just couldn't pass, 25 cents. Scanner is on here. Richard Kirk of Cabaret Voltaire. The Irresistible Force. Speedy J, Paul Van Dyke. Pentatonic. Hard Floor. A quarter! Even though it's beat. Three album set. Wow, yeah. Mozart, violin sonatas on gramophone. You know, it's virtually new. Have to get the gramophones when you see them. Cheap. Gotta grab these. Fletcher Henderson, double LP, jazz tribute to the Fletcher. Again, for those that have their jazz history down, know how important Fletcher Henderson was to the development of big band jazz. His arrangements, I understand. Not I understand, I know I've heard them. I just can't tell you anything about them in my head. I believe Duke Ellington owes, among others, owes a credit to this man. Where is this made? This is an import. This is made in France. 25 cents. Double album. Love it. Pick this up. Dave Pell plays Duke Ellington's Big Band Sounds. I had one of these where he was playing Tito Puente. If I remember correctly, I gave it to Chris... 4127 Basket in Switzerland. But I found another Dave Pell album. Plays Duke Ellington. On that old style yellow vinyl. 25 cents. I went ahead and grabbed this for 25 cents. This is a local cat, Ron Cooley, who plays in Mannheim Steamroller. I've played with him. I've, you know, known him forever. It's on the American Gramophone label, which is out of Omaha. This one is in good shape, so I went ahead and grabbed it. All-time great bloopers. We'll see what's on here. Double album. This will be fun. I don't remember this. King. Steps in Time. I remember that. I don't know that I liked this, but it was, again, it was a chord. Prefab Sprout, The Golden Calf single. Quarter. I had to pick this up. Mullens. Because of the label, Bronco. Again, I gave an album on this label to Chris. Could be some salts or something like that. I already have this, but I couldn't pass it up. It's a perfect condition of Scriabin Symphony No. 2. This version. So now I have two of it. Horse Lips. Short Stories, Tall Tales. Another one. Art Pepper and George Cables. Tete-a-Tete. Bull Inviter. Behind the Gardens, Behind the Wall, Under the Tree. I like his music very much. Let me just, okay. Let's Active. A quarter. Justin Hayward, songwriter. There should be a couple good songs in here. I'm a Moody Blues lover, but also I love this old label, Duran, so I can pass it up. Look at this. PFM Cook for a quarter. I have it already. Dixie Dregs for a quarter. This was mine. I remember trading it, and it's like I'm glad I got it back because it has sentimental value to me. You know, I got an upgrade, but this ring wear is well earned, and it's got my name in it. Can you see that? Yeah. That goes all the way back. I had to get it back. Just a couple more. This was fun. Cambridge Buskers on Deutsche Grammophon. Mesopotamia, B-52s. I had to get it for a quarter. This is the one that Brian got upset about. Gatto Barbieri on Impulse for a quarter. Still had the store price on it, so somebody was just being foolish. So this was real nice on Impulse. 25 cents. This is, I'm looking forward to this. Vladimir Kozma. He does the soundtrack to this movie, The Mad Adventures of Rabbi Jacob. Vladimir Kozma is a fantastic composer of library and soundtrack music. I was real happy to find this. And for a quarter, Vladimir Kozma. It's like, it looks like it's never been played. Score. Man, this was fun today. Fun. Just see what else. Pick this up, The Call, Reconciled for a quarter. Not the biggest fan of Wynton Marsalis, but again, looking at what it is, it's like for a quarter. It's a classical debut recording with the gold seal and all that stuff. It's like, shit, sure. Scritti Politti, Whidbey's 12-inch single. Yeah, anything else? Yeah, I picked this up. Billy Thorpe, 21st Century Man, the guy that made that, what's the record? Children of the Sun. I guess it's supposed to be part two of that. The record's in great shape. China Crisis, Flaunt the Imperfection. Record's in great shape. Steve Morse Band. You know, he's with Deep Purple now, was with Dixie Dregs. And then the last thing I picked up was Wasmonar Is. I didn't show everything, but wow. 25 cent finds. It was fun today.